live from your news leader. This is WTAJ News This Morning in high definition.
Graham Spanier, Tim Curley, Gary Schultz will head to trial for what prosecutors call a conspiracy of silence, accused of covering up information involving Jerry Sandusky investigations. But what does this mean for Penn State? How are students reacting? WTAJ News reporter Mallory Lane spoke to some on campus to see what the atmosphere was like there.
District Judge William Wenner bound all charges against Graham Spanier, Tim Curley, and Gary Schultz to trial Tuesday, but not before giving the court a piece of his mind. Just before his announcement Tuesday, he said, quote, "Today is a tragic day for Penn State." Penn State Board of Trustees member Anthony Lebrano was in the courtroom both days. He agrees with Wenner's statement, saying he's disappointed in his alma mater.
This has been a very tragic experience for Penn State, and this is another one of those days. It doesn't make me feel good as a Penn Stater that we're in this position.
When the whole scandal broke, I was like, why am I going to school here?
Penn State sophomore Taylor Castleberry was a freshman when the scandal first broke in November 2011. He says since then, things have died down and doesn't think Tuesday's ruling will change that.
I would say things are pretty much normal around here right now, despite what's going on right now at Old Main, but other than that, I would say I'm proud to go to school here.
Freshman Andrea Gunderson feels the same. She says Wednesday has been business as usual.
I didn't even feel like the community was hit that much. The atmosphere up here is just all about Penn State, and we're one big family.
Victim 5 attorney Tom Klein commended Penn State Monday for addressing victims' claims, but says the university won't be able to really heal until it settles with the victims and this trial is over.
The fact of the matter is that unless and until this matter reaches a conclusion, Penn State, which has tried to move forward, continues to be in a position where this process bogs down that attempt.
Reporting in State College, Mallory Lane, WTAJ News This Morning.
Now the defense attorneys for all three men, Curley, Schultz, and Spanier, say they hope the trial will allow the truth about what they say happened to come out, and they maintain their client's innocence. The trial is expected to begin as early as March.